Do you want two different men in your womb at the same time?
If I love him and I feel attracted to him, yes, I don't mind. But I do entertain the idea that if a man can have 3-4 wives, why can't a woman have two
husbands? You can't, Lisa.
Love her. If those two men love her and they don't want to be.
You're not designed for that.
But wait, hold on. So you really want two different men in you all the time?
They don't have to, all the time.
Maybe it doesn't matter. At some point in time, two different men are in you all the time, whether it's every other month.
What about if it's a sexless relationship?
What's the point? If the whole point is creation, is procreation.
And right? Rihanna is absolutely okay. Right, according to the Bible. Are you an adept believer or are you just tap dancing?
Then what's the point?
The Most High gave an order to be fruitful and multiply. He was telling men to do this with women, right? Women that would actually be wives or concubines. Is it not a fact that women could actually only get pregnant once in a year? She's locked down for the next 9.5 to 10 months. Men can impregnate women every day. Most people don't understand in the Hebrew Bible, there's a mandate. The first commandment is considered to be the commandment to be fruitful and multiply in Genesis 1:28. That is not an option. That is an order. So that means the Most High is telling us right there from the inception of creation that abortion is forbidden, that having casual sex and pulling out is forbidden. In fact, why don't I go to that? Yeah, first I would like to make it abundantly clear that the Most High gave a commandment in Genesis 1:28 to be fruitful and multiply. And then once he destroyed the world and decided to rebuild it with Noah and his descendants and their wives, he said, as for you, be fruitful and multiply, bring forth abundantly in the earth and multiply in it. So are you women out there that think that you could actually just have sex with contraceptions? All of that is against the Most High. That came out of Egypt. That is Egypt's wickedness. It is a natural act to have sex and not to pull out. When you pull out, you're going against the will of the Most High. As we see the Most High kill Onan for pulling out and wasting his seed.
Some books.
Oh, yeah. I know.
You need to write you some book because you came up with everything to avoid.
No, you know what?
Accountability.
Two men,
on behalf of the women.
You're negating the fact that you do go out here miscellaneously and decide that you're going to sleep with women. You're talking about the woman, but you can't. Okay, if you don't get hard, how does that woman be able to get your penis inside of her? Do entertain the idea that if a man can have 3-4 wives, why can't a woman have two?
You can't, Lisa.
Why can't a woman have two?
You can't, Lisa.
Why can't a woman have two?
You can't, Lisa.
Love her. If those two men love her and they don't want to be.
You're not designed for that.
But wait, hold on. So you really want two different men in you all the time?
Love her. If those two men love her and they don't want to be.
Wait, hold on. So you really want two different men in you all the time?
They don't have to.
It doesn't matter. At some point in time, two different men are in you all the time, whether it's every other month.
What about if it's a sexless relationship?
What's the point? If the whole point is creation, is procreation, right?
Okay.
Amongst other things, if the whole reason for sex is procreation, and that's the biggest thing, then what's the point?
And so this is what we mean by worldly. You've taken on the paradigm mindset of the world and not of the Most High. The Most High is against a man pulling out, a man masturbating, just to prevent pregnancy. Because the whole point of sex that the Most High used it for was to be fruitful and multiply, which is why he was displeased with Onan and killed them for pulling out in the book of Bereshit, Genesis 38, verse 9. Onan had no problem having sex with Tamar, using her body for his pleasure, but he wanted to make sure that he would not provide his brother an heir. So the Most High was very unhappy with that arrangement. And so what he did was actually displeasing to the Most High in the Most High's sight, and the Most High put him to death in Genesis 38, verse 10.
Why would you have a man there to not procreate with, and that's your husband? Why would you deny him and give him what a husband should be given? That help me make that make sense. Okay. You want two different.
What about if you already inside you have kids and you're not having any more kids and you just want a good husband?
No. No, I'm saying with the scenario I just asked you, you want two different phallacies up inside of you. Is that what you want as a woman? That's what you want. You want two different men knocking you down.
Listen, if you're with a man and he's sleeping with four different women.
That's where I'm asking you a simple question. It's a yes or no. Do you want two different men in your womb?
If I love him and I feel attracted to him, yes, I don't mind.
Do you want two different men in your womb at the same time?
If I love him and I feel attracted to him, yes, I don't mind.
So yes, that's for you, right?
I mean, I'm just saying, I don't see the difference in if I have an attraction.
How do you not see the difference? And then you get pregnant. Whose baby is it?
Yeah, I heard this story from a Muslim lady that told
It's not a story. That's reality. You have two different sperms up inside your womb. Okay, who's the father?
But isn't that the same? It's the same.
No, ma'am. It's never the same.
Okay.
It's never the same.
Listen, it's the same thing with a man having four.
It absolutely
is not the same.
It absolutely is not. When a man can spread his seed is different than what a woman can take. A woman wasn't designed to have multiple dicks up in her, period. She just wasn't.
Okay.
Hey, book zip zap. With all due respect, you don't believe in the Most High God.
Yeah, she doesn't.
You damn sure don't believe in the Torah or the Bible.
Hold on, you guys.
You wicked.
Hold on, Kings.
I believe in
you can't compare apples to oranges. A man is not a woman, and a woman is not a man. By nature, we are nurturous. We nurture, right? Mm-hmm. We're more emotional or tapped in to our emotions differently because of our nurturing, because we rear children. We have breasts, not just because they look good, because they produce milk. So many things we have, we store more fat. Why? So that way we can handle pregnancies. We are different. We are not the same as men, period.
I agree with that.
And we all may have masculine and feminine at times, but again, it still comes a certain way. Just like a man is a leader, he's assertive. There's certain qualities that are just innate. It's just what God has given a man, different than what he's given a woman. Mm-hmm. And it's for a reason. We are to receive. That's just what it is. We get something, and what do they say? We make a house a home. A man comes to us and gives us something, we make a business. We multiply everything that's given. We make it grow. We make it multiply. That's what we do.
But do all women do that though?
That's not
okay. Let me say this to you, Lisa.
Hold on, Lisa.
Let me address
knowing
that.
Knowing that it's not someone you want to
let me address
have a
that.
Baby with.
Let me address that. Right. Okay. So. Our natures are not the same. Our natures are not the same. We're not designed the same. You could hope and pray that you could be like a man, but you could never be like a man, right? Huh. So first and foremost, let's start right here. All right. If you went out to a club, you got pregnant by Lil Ray Ray, right? Now, you got pregnant by Lil Ray Ray Wednesday night. You're pregnant. How many more times in 9.5 to 10 months can you go out and get pregnant by the other guys, by another guy?
You can't. No. So.
Okay. Stop. Before you go off. All right. Let's say I went out, right? I went out. I got Tiffany pregnant. 2 hours later, I went to a different club. I got Lisa pregnant. I went to a different club. 2 hours later, I re-up, got energized again, drunk some ginseng. Then I got Pam pregnant. So I got three females pregnant in the same night. I'm going to have three children pretty much almost born around the same time span. Okay. Now my question to you is, why did the Most High give that ability to man that you don't have? And what makes you think that you have a right to deprive a man of that capacity when the Most High gave it to him? But you don't have that same ability. But you're saying, if he could do it, I could do it. So science alone is trying to teach you that you're not supposed to do that, because your body is not designed to do that.
Children is one thing. Relationships are another.
No, it's not. No, that's a sign. That's a sign of what we're able to do. And people that have common sense will listen to that and say, wow, why can't I do that? You know? But we want to tap dance around the truth.
Okay, so suppose you're married to a woman for 20 years, but you just don't see eye to eye. You are there because you're raising your child, but you don't have a connection with her. You're raising your child. You're there for that reason. How many people stay in marriages and they're just there until the child goes to college or whatever? He's sleeping downstairs. She's sleeping upstairs. It's dysfunctional. The child doesn't see love and affection. The child doesn't see a family unit.
What does that have to do with what I was saying?
What I'm saying to you is, a lot of the times, the same thing that you're talking about is more like, okay, your mind, a kid is one thing, but a kid is not who you are definitively. So
what this has nothing to do with what I was showing you, that you're not biologically designed the way that men are.
Dodging and ducking.
The point was showing you that you're not biologically designed to do what men could do. You said that you can, but you can't.
Hold on.
You know the only reason that you could do that is because you're following the wickedness of the Egyptians. You know that contraception came from Egyptians, right? Egyptians was the first one that came out with contraceptions to prevent women from getting pregnant so they could practice sexual wickedness.
Oh.